big commotion that's spreading to the ocean from sea to shining sea. There is no hesitating. Today we're celebrating Ariel's melody. Today with Triton's daughter comes back here to the...
Hello, everyone, and welcome to my latest movie review, where today I review the direct-to-video Disney sequel, The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. Yeah, The Little Mermaid 2. Fuck this shit. Anyway, the reason why I'm reviewing this is because one of the actors, Samuel E. Wright, who voices Sebastian the Crab, recently passed away. I did a little text tribute at the start as well, but... Yeah, Samuel E. Wright was a big part of The Little Mermaid's success, you know? He voiced Sebastian, who's the Jamaican crab, and a very talented actor, among all accounts. He also appeared in the film Dinosaur, where he voiced Crone. So he had a couple of films linked to Disney, and I'm sure he had other film credits as well, but those are the only ones I know him for. But yeah, I just want to send my condolences very quickly to him. He died recently due to losing battle against cancer, and he was about 74 years old. So yeah, I hope he's resting in peace. Anyway, on with the film. So The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. Basically, the story is, it kind of takes place after, I think about a year or so after the first one. And basically the plot is as follows. To protect her from a sea witch, Ariel's daughter is not allowed in the ocean. But when she becomes 12, she runs away to an adventure under the sea. And adding further to that, basically we focus on Melody, who is Ariel and Eric's daughter, and she basically comes across Ursula's crazy sister, Morgana, and is manipulated by her into stealing the trident for, yeah, the same exact reasons as Ursula did in the first movie. The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. I realise that I am probably not the target audience of this film, but bearing in mind the fact that I actually really like The Little Mermaid, the original film, I think it's a really, really great film, and it's very sweet. It's a great coming-of-age story, and it's a great love story. It's such a fantastical film in many aspects. This movie is not. This movie is a shameless rehash of the first one. Literally, it is the first film in reverse. Basically, the first film was Ariel wanting to become human, and this one, Melody wants to become a mermaid. Same difference. The fact that the villain is Ursula's sister, I mean, couldn't they not have thought of something a bit more original than that? I mean, even the same actress comes back to voice Ursula's sister. I mean, I suppose I could see why they did that. I mean, Pat Carroll, you know, amazing vocal performance in both films. But to me, she's just a shameless Ursula reject. I mean, you know, what was the point? You know, I'd rather them spend time working out a new character rather than just basically doing a second model of Ursula. That's kind of how it feels like with Morgana. I mean, this movie's not horrible. I mean, I don't hate it. I just don't like it. I just think that it doesn't do anything or add anything to this series of films. As for the cast, well, a lot of the cast do actually return from the first film, which is good because the gap isn't so long. I mean, the first film was released in 1989, I believe. So and the second film was released in 2000, so yeah. Obviously, Samuel E. Wright, rest in peace, as Sebastian. He is probably the best in the cast. He is just funny. He's hilarious. He doesn't get to do as many musical routines in this one as he did in the first one, but he's the thing that keeps this film barely afloat. No pun intended. Jodie Benson returns as Ariel, and you can hear in her voice that she's matured and she's gotten older, and that's fine, and I think she does a good job, and although I question the writing with Ariel at one point. Tara Strong plays Melody. Melody's all right. I don't rate her that much as a protagonist. At points, the performance comes off as very sort of whimsical and a bit cheesy. Like, the voice is, you know, she's trying too hard to be kind of overly sweet and, I don't know, schmaltzy. That's kind of how I feel about Melody. She's a bit schmaltzy and she's a bit whiny. I know she's a young kid and she's just learning to grow up. Still, I can't, like, Melody's, you know, she just slightly annoyed me a little bit. I don't know what it was. She just kind of annoyed me. I just don't like her story. The whole fact that she is, no pun intended, a fish out of water, stuck in the wrong place, being mocked and abused by everyone because she talks to sea creatures. And the whole, like, liar cliche, the fact that, you know, her parents lied to her about where she really comes from. It's, the plot is so... It's just so boring. We've seen this type of plot before. I don't understand why Ariel would want to deprive her daughter of her heritage. I mean, yeah, okay, there's a crazy witch woman on the loose, but the, you know, Ariel's dad is the king of the fucking ocean. So surely he would put intense security measures in place to make sure that Melody was safe. And you know what? There's a 12-year gap between the beginning of this movie and then the next scene. So surely Morgana would have attempted to steal the trident within that 12-year time frame. So, you know, I don't think what difference it would have made to build a wall around the human world and seal Melody off from the ocean. You know, what's the point? You know, it's stupid. What annoys me also is Eric. You know, Eric, he doesn't get anything to do in this film. And it's a real shame. Like, he's Melody's dad, and they never interact. They literally never interact. There's a scene where Melody argues with her mother, and then she storms out crying from the bedroom, and she just runs past her dad, and he's like, Ariel, darling. It's like, dude, tend to your fucking daughter. She's crying. She's in a state. I mean, come on. The only time he talks to his daughter is when she's getting ready for the party. That's it. Eric is wasted in this film. He could have been utilized so much more. Flounder makes a bit of an appearance as well. And like I said, most of the cast do return. Like we have Carlo Turin, Chef Louis, you know, they're all back. We also have Scuttle. I don't know why Scuttle's in it, really. He doesn't have that much humor as he did in the first one, and the humor's not as strong. And we have some new characters, and to be honest, the new characters are okay. I don't really care much for them. We have this penguin and this walrus called Tip and Dash, who, as the Nostalgia Critic described, are basically Timon and Pumbaa at sea. That's basically who they are. They're a very odd pairing, and they're trying to be heroes or something, but they're actually cowards. And yeah, it's a stupid sort of part of the story, really. It doesn't go anywhere. And then they meet Melody, and they have to sort of step up and save her, and yada yada yada. They're basically throwaway characters, and the story wouldn't have mattered if they weren't in it, to be honest. And there's Undertow, who's this massive shark he's a massive shark at the beginning, and then he gets shrunk into a tiny shark, and he's remains tiny for most of the film. For me, the humor of this film is also not great. I mean, I suppose kids might find it funny, but I don't know, to me it just didn't have the sort of punchiness as much as the first film. It didn't also have the emotional weight of the first film, despite that they tried to make you feel sorry for Melody and her situation, especially during the argument scene. But I just could not emotionally invest in this one, whereas the first film, I could totally emotionally invest in this one, because you could understand that Ariel was a teenager, so she was growing up, and she was at that age where, you know, she was changing, and you know, life was going to go in a new direction for her, and she was going to discover love and all of that stuff, and she was going to defy her dad. You know, there was a believable dynamic with Triton and Ariel in the first movie. In this one, maybe it's because Melody's 12. I don't know, like, the fact that she's 12, maybe it would have been better to make her slightly older, maybe to make her a teenager, but I don't know. Like, it just, to me, this plot was just completely forgettable, and it didn't really go anywhere. To me, Melody as a character never changed. Like, from the beginning to the end, she doesn't really learn anything. She basically gets to have both worlds, you know. She gets a choice from her grandfather, where he says, you know, I'm going to let you choose whether you want to stay with us in Atlantica, or you can stay at home. And she's like, no, I have a better idea. So she basically merges the two worlds back together again, which is, you know, the most predictable ending you could have thought of. But like, as a character, what has Melody actually learned from this experience? Like, nothing. And the final confrontation with Morgana is just so bad. It's just really weightless, and it didn't do anything for me, to be perfectly honest. It's supposed to be a powerful moment when Melody is running up the ice and climbing and facing Morgana. Yeah, I don't really get what it's supposed to signify, but okay, fair enough. And as for the songs, they're okay. Like, they're perfectly all right, but I would never listen to them again. They're not as good as the songs in the original film, of course. I mean, the only times I really enjoyed the movie were really when Sebastian was on screen, because Sebastian was hilarious. He was funny. But otherwise, this movie is really bad. I've seen worse Disney sequels. It's not the worst. I mean, some of the animation isn't too bad. Considering it is a straight-to-video sequel, the animation is better than certain efforts from other franchises. Like, the Undersea World looks pretty cool. I mean, not as interesting as the first film, but good enough. And it's short, you know, it's only 1 hour 20 minutes, so it's not going to be too long to sit through. But, yeah, for me, The Little Mermaid 2 is a very disappointing movie. I don't hate it. I think some of the songs are fine enough. I think some of the characters are good enough. There's some nice humour from Sebastian. The story is kind of muddled, to be honest. I just think the film suffers from being basically exactly the same. It's a rehash. The plot is the same as the first one. It's just reversed. So to give this one an overall rating, I would probably have to give The Little Mermaid 2... I'm going to give it a 4 out of 10. Oh, it's only big emotion that's spread into the ocean from sea to shining sea. There is no hesitating. Today we're celebrating Ariel's melody. Today when Triton's daughter comes back here to the water, we're going to have a spree. So anyway, that's my review of The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. Will I review Ariel's Beginning? Possibly, yeah, I might review that. I haven't actually seen that one, so that would be an interesting one to review. But yes, rest in peace to Samuel E. Wright, who voiced Sebastian. My thoughts and prayers go with him and his family. Anyway, thank you very much all for watching this review. What do you think of this film? Please comment down below, let me know, and stay tuned next time for more reviews. Please hit that subscribe button if you would like to see more content. And as always, I'm Mr. Tardis 11. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye for now.